Okay.
Hello, my name is Pedro Gomes, and I am a researcher and developer at Arquivo.pt, which is a service provided by the Portuguese government. I will present a use case to illustrate how we apply automated seed selections at Arquivo.pt to perform special crawls on specific topics, like Afghan websites with limited resources. The Arquivo.pt is a Portuguese web archive initiative which preserves historical web content. Arquivo.pt permanently selects, archives, and provides public access to its web collection. So in these examples, we can see on the left side the oldest Portuguese web page from Coimbra University from 1993, and the oldest image from SpaceLink from 1992. We are continuously indexing the preserved information in order to be free so anyone can search and view. And at the same time, we also increase our collections and user community. For instance, we did automated seed selections to complete the dataset from Horizon 2020, since 47% of the project URL were missing. Now about the automated seed selection to preserve Afghan websites. In this workshop, I will present an example done by us recently, Afghanistan. Everyone knows the consequences of Taliban's victory. So first, we need to understand the problem, the topic, the information needed, and the resources available. So what is the scope of this collection? In our case, the main goal of Arquivo.pt is to preserve online information from scientific and academic purpose. So it will not be necessary to collect all the Afghan websites. And right now we have a few resources available for this task. Second, what are the language of the sites that you want to find? English or Pashto and Dari, which are the official language for Afghanistan. And finally, how many URLs, disk space, and human effort we want to invest to create this collection. Next, we need to find patterns and keywords for the topic. In this example, we saw an interesting pattern. Most of the government website end with gov.af. So, based on the tension between the government and the Taliban, we think that most of the government websites will be changed or gone. So we decided to follow the set of keywords to be preserved. And we also did a human testing of the patterns to see if the results are good or not. And as referenced before, our main goal is to collect research articles and publications. So we also add the keyword research. Now I will explain the tool that we use, Bing Search API, which is the API from bing.com. You can use the free version from Bing Search API, however, with limited number of requests. In our case, we have the premium version, which is inside Microsoft Azure. Finally, Bing Search API has different type of search. You can see the web page, image search, entity, video, and user. You can define the query, the number of requests, the age value by day, week, and month, the country where the results come from, and the market where the results come from. These are the most simple parameters. There are more. If you want to know more about Bing Search API, you can check the link. So to do a more targeted search, we have to answer a set of questions. First, what are the number of results per query? 10, 20? Do you want a specific language, a specific regions, which type of resources, and so on? Based on the answers for this question, it's necessary to specify the previous parameters that I explained before. Now I will explain briefly the code, an example. In here you can see the arguments that the script takes, the number of results, the key for Microsoft Azure, and the query lists. Then you can see the code to process the response from Bing Search API and export to tab separated format. In here you can see the request to Bing Search API with a JSON, and then you can see the process to check the results. Now you can see an example of the query research. You can see the results are good results. But if sometimes the results are not good, and if possible, you can refine the results. For instance, for the query London, results like TripAdvisor are most likely irrelevant. Here you can see the workflow to automate its selections, understand the problem, find the patterns, human testing, define the parameters for Vintage API, run the code, and then refine the results if possible. Some numbers about the collection. This collection is from 17 August 2021 until 3 of September 2021. We have stored 391 gigabytes of information that correspond to 3.4 million of collected files. The resource, half a day of digital curator and half a day of an engineer and one computer for 2000 seats. Now you can see some examples, the websites. This is not perfect, but we were able to do this with limited resources and in a short amount of time. The purpose of the process is not to replace the work of the human curators, but rather to increase their responsiveness due to the large information that is currently being produced. Some conclusions. The code for the examples are on GitHub. We also did a transnational and cross-language crawl of the European Parliament elections from 2019. If you want to see more information, you can check the presentation in the YouTube link. We also apply automated selection in this project. And finally, if you do a research based on this collection or other collections from archive.pt, you can apply to archive.pt annual awards and you can win 10,000 euros. You can check on archive.pt/awards. If you have any suggestions, please can send us an email. Thank you.